Hey, what's going on, everyone? My name is John. I'm a filmmaker slash creator and your host for Make Lemonade Podcast, where we talk about how to change our circumstances when life happens. In other words, when life gives you lemons, make lemonade. Today, we are talking about being born in the water. Welcome everyone. I'm so glad that you are here today. Today we're talking about being born in the water. I know it sounds crazy, right? But let me tell you, it's a good message today that you're going to be elevated, motivated. I mean, I'm telling you, it's going to do something for you today, okay? So you have something good for you to start with this morning, whether you are exercising, whether you're getting up for work, whether you're taking your kids to school, or whatever you may be doing, maybe getting some coffee in the morning, which is something that I like to do, getting my nice black coffee, which is what I like to drink. Anyways, so let's talk about being born in the water. Recently, like about, and what I mean recently, I don't mean like maybe like 2 hours ago, maybe like yesterday. When I say recently, I mean like pretty much along the lines about 7 to 8 weeks ago. I know I got I was able to get a avocado tree. Okay. And the reason why I say that is because I bought a jumbo avocado and I saw the seed and I was like, what better time than now to, you know, get an avocado seed and make it into a tree, right? At least that's what I wanted to do. And so I went online to look, how can I start this avocado tree? And along the lines, I came to discover that a lot of people would put this avocado in this process. So what you do is you take the avocado the seed from the avocado, and you take it, you wash it, you peel off the little skin that it has on top, then you poke on it 3 little toothpicks, and then you fill up a cup or, you know, jug, whatever it is, like a little pint probably size, and then you put the avocado on top, and of course it's hanging by the toothpicks that you put, and you just leave it there. In about 10 weeks you should be getting some roots coming out, and then you put it into a pot with soil and then you let it grow. That's the beginning process of it, right? And then it happens that I saw, because I was thinking, I was like, well, why don't they just automatically put it into the soil so it can grow, right? At least that's the way I was thought to, you know, seed grows, right? Seed is in the floor or in the ground. It grows within the ground. That's its area of growing. And, you know, a lot of people were saying, put it in water. And I was like, okay. So I went on and I had to answer that question. So I went on YouTube to check, right? The YouTube of universities. and I end up coming to this video where the guy tests a avocado born in water and an avocado born in dirt. And what I mean born, I mean he literally submerge, I think I'm saying it wrong. Well, he literally put the seeds in the dirt and then one seed in the water to see what was the difference between them both. And then after the root would come out from the one in the water, you would transfer it into a soil. He wanted to see what was the difference because he had the same question that I did. Why are people putting it in water, and which one grows better? At the end of the day, the one that grew on the soil was strong, was beautiful. Its leaves were lively. The one that was born in the water, when it was transferred, well, when it was in the water, it was growing beautiful, and then it was transferred into the dirt, and it had a hard time adapting to the dirt. And then once it got itself together, it grew, and they had to like trim some of the leaves or some of the stems for it to grow better, and then it started getting a little better. But the avocado tree born in the soil was automatically strong. Like from the beginning, it was beautiful, it was dark, it was green, it was just flourishing versus the one that was transferred. It had a hard time transferring into its place until it was able to catch on and then keep moving. So that is what happened to the avocado tree, and I ended up coming to the conclusion that if something like an avocado is born in the water, then the avocado tree literally that becomes its atmosphere, that becomes its home, and that becomes what it was born into. Okay, versus the one in the soil, which is typically what a seed is known from like let's just say from birth, right? From the its beginning, its purpose and its creation is to be born in soil, versus an avocado tree where people put it in water for I don't know what reasons, but they put it in water so that it can like grow its roots, and then you put it in the soil, and then it happens, right? Which I didn't understand because, again, my process was put it in soil, seeds grow in soil. So when it comes to this, and we're talking about being born in the water, my first topic goes into being born in the water typically means being born in a place where only you know your surroundings. You make that your home. You make that your area. What happens in this place when you are born in a certain area, in a certain place, with a certain belief, with a certain bringing of teaching and morals? That's all you know. Okay, that's all you know. Now, is that typically a bad thing or is it a good thing? That is a good question. And that's what we're going to talk about today. Because it can be a misconception if you understand it wrong. Because there's one thing that I do believe, and that is if you believe in nothing, you fall for anything. So I would rather someone have them believe in something than not believe in anything and just be back and forth with things around, very like the water puts it, very like water, you know, it goes here, it goes there, it goes anywhere the wind pushes it, right? And that in its place, it's not something that is that has a foundation but that just goes anywhere. That's very, very hard to have a mindset of belief. And I think in this time, a lot of people that I've seen are like water at this time. You know, and not like Bruce Lee water or be like water, you know, not like that. But what I mean with water, I mean that they don't have a center where they believe in something, but their center is on trends, on what people are believing at the moment, what people are fighting for at the moment, instead of what they believe. Because trends come and go, right? Trends come from an area of a generation, and then the next generation may not believe what the generation before did. It's what ha like in the process of my life, I've seen generations and generations change mindsets after mindsets. For example, one of the biggest one was makeup. You know, from wearing simple makeup to wearing like extravagant makeup to wearing like glam makeup to wearing like makeup that was back from the 60s or makeup that was from the 90s, and mixing that with what today's trends are. And you know, that's been something that I've seen over time. And the reason why I talk about makeup is because it's because I have a person that I know that is into makeup. They literally mastered that area in their life, and they teach it, they have business in it. And so that is what I have seen over time within the process of knowing this person. And it comes to me to a point of seeing that if you are born into something, you're going to believe that. There's been cultures and there's been tests that people have done where either a culture or you live in a certain area and you're surrounded by that, that's exactly what you're going to believe. That's exactly what you're going to act like. And I think in so many cases, it can be very dramatic, or what's the word that I'm looking for? Radical, very radical, that a person believes in something and others don't. And I think that's when the chaos happens, because if you don't believe in anything, but you're wishy-washy, right, with like the water going here and going there, being pushed by the wind, you're going to have a hard time believing in something, because literally you're going to be everywhere, right? You're going to be everywhere with your opinions. You're going to be everywhere with what you're saying. And sometimes it's not going to make sense what you're trying to say. And typically, that is almost like being born in a place. You know, people in today's world, as another example, like the new young generation that are being born, they're growing up with technology. A kid knows how to handle an iPad or a computer at the age of 5 or 10 than an adult that is now probably in their 50s or 60s or above, and they know how to maneuver through the internet more than that person does. Now, that's not all cases, but my point is that generation is being born into something that they have not been introduced to. So, just as the avocado tree was born into water, and the other seed was born in dirt, they both grew up different in their process, right? The one in the avocado tree grew up in soil, which was its place to grow up. And then the other avocado tree was born into water. Its roots were born into water, and that's what it knew. But yet, when the avocado tree was transferred into the soil, it was impacted because it was not what it knew. Okay? And the reason why I say this is because, let's say the dirt is the world that we live in, right? And the person that is born in that world knows that world, is born into that world, they know that world. So when a person that is born into water, which is a different belief, comes into the world, their belief is challenged. Their belief is, in a way, pressured, because the world believes in a certain way that things run. And when someone comes with a different belief, that belief is challenged because of it. Now, depending on what they do, whether they surrender to the belief or whether they keep their belief and they make an impact, there's going to be a transformation when that happens. Okay, there's going to be a challenge of survival, as for the avocado born in water into dirt. So if you're born in the water, you have a belief that you're believing in. Right, for example, me, I believe in the faith, in Bible, and that's my process. That's what I was born with. And when I came into the world, right, I was born in the church, and then when I came into the world, as an example, as a soil, when I came into contact with other people, like in the school area and children, and I was a kid myself, my view on things were very different than those of the people that were there. And what kept me from being, I say, the same was the actual belief that I kept myself to, which was what my parents taught me. Typically, that's every kid, right? Every kid sticks to what their parents teach them, and they take that throughout their years in their life. And it was very interesting for me to go into places, and every time that I would go into a different place and a different soil that was accustomed to, and then I would come with my belief was always a challenge. Whether it be because the majority did not believe it, whether it be because the majority were in a different place of a trend. That place, and the soil does not have to be the world representative. The soil can be any place that's already founded under that one thing. Just like water, water is founded under water, dirt is founded under dirt. Those are two different things, but yet they coincide in the same area, right? You have sand, you have water, you have dirt next to sand. I mean, everybody has their own place, but they in some way they function with each other. So what happens in this place when you're born into water, like I said, and you go into a place of change? And like I was saying to you, in my time, everywhere that I went, there was always something that was challenging my belief. When I first came into school of the university, the challenge was very different because it was the time of transferring where Hispanics were being pushed to go to school, go to college, I mean. And by I mean push, I mean they were seeing that the minority of Hispanics were not going to college, so they were trying to push and motivate more Hispanics to go to college by providing tuition, by providing a low payment on schools for their entrance and different stuff like that. And they were trying to get more people to go into these areas so that they could have a percentage of Hispanics and check mark that in their school, right? So going into that transformation for me was in some ways difficult and in some ways not, because I was in the beginning of entering a place. Because when I grew up, what I heard was Hispanics don't go to college. Hispanics are going to school. Hispanics don't finish college. There's few, we're the minorities. We're the minorities and Latinos minorities. But yet, when I went to college, there were a lot of Hispanics that were in college. And because, again, we were in the transformation of, I believe in my generation, more Hispanics were actually paying attention into going to college and having a degree, at least a bachelor's. And so that was the transformation that I was in. Now you have the transformation of, is school even necessary? Is university even necessary? Because you're left paying debt, right? When you don't have the free financial aid that they give you money. And if you have loans, then you end up paying those loans because even your financial aid wasn't even enough for your payments for the school. And now you're left with 20, 50, 100 grand left in your school for going to college. And now you have to pay those by getting a job and paying it back. And that takes up to 10, 15, 20, even 50 years to even pay that off. Right? And can you imagine 20, 50 years of your life paying off loans, plus paying off your house, paying off cars because you got a degree to have a job that sometimes people don't even like. That is called coming from a place of being born in water and coming into a place where your belief is challenged. So, how do we face this situation? How do we go from a place of transformation? Do we give in to the trends? Do we face the odds? What do we do? Well, I'm going to tell you right now exactly what to do. There's this time where, in the Bible, Jesus is telling the people to, now, of course, I'm going to paraphrase this. When you talk to someone else about what they're doing or another person and their belief, one of the things that you must do is have a conversation that is not about argument, that is not about, my thing is better than yours, but instead sit down and discuss your belief and my belief. For the reasons of this, one, you want to know what's there, right? You want to know what other people are believing, and you want to see the differences so that you can understand your difference and their differences. And that's pretty much it. You create that space where you're not fighting people because they don't believe what you believe. You're not attacking people because they don't believe what you believe. But instead, you're having conversations with them and seeing why they do what they do. Because again, even though people are born in the soil, for example, in a trend, or they're born in a generation that believes a certain way, sometimes you'll get people that are just going along with it. They're going along with the ride, and that's it. They don't really believe in it. And then you have some that actually do believe in it and are 100% into it. And that's what you want to know. You want to know the differences. You want to know why. Because you want to know exactly what you believe in. And you want to see how other people are living in this world to see how you can use your belief in that world. And that's the simple process of transformation. Okay, and there are some adaptations that you're going to have to, adaptations that you're going to have to literally go through. Okay, and does that mean that you have to try every single thing? No, it does not mean you have to try every single thing. But what it does mean is that there's a process where you go through so that you're not in a place of war. You're not in a place of fighting. You're not in a place of destroying each other because you believe different. But there's a place where you go and you accept people for who they are. You accept people for what they do. And in that return, you actually have more impact in people's lives because of what you believe, because of what you stand for. And the reason why I say this is because I've seen a lot of people through my lifetime believe in something only because their friends believe in it, or only because it's cool, or only because most of what they grew up with, they believed in it. And they just go along the lines there, and or they're lost in their world, and they're trying to escape into something that is accepts them for who they are. And I've seen this over and over and over again. And one thing that has kept me still on my foundation, not perfect, but has kept me on my belief, has been the process of actually living what I say. Even if I fail at times in the belief of what I say. Because that process is always a process of understanding. It was I given into the belief of that culture? Was I falling into the belief of what they were doing? And it happens because in communication, one of the things is you have the majority and you have the minority. If the majority it believes in something, most likely people are to go to the majority. But the ones that are in the minority, they're literally seen as people who are either selfish, who are radical, who are, very independent, very strong in their belief, very direct. Why? Because they're the minorities. People sometimes outcast them because of it and think of them weird because of it. But yet, those are the ones that make a difference. So, again, where do you stand in this? If you are born in the water, you come from a place when people believe differently, but then you go into an area where people don't believe what you believe. Are you offended over the fact that they don't believe what you do? Or do you learn about why they don't? In business, one of the most important things to understand and to get messages across is a clear communication. And that's the process here when you are in a transfer, like the avocado went into the dirt. There was no clear communication, and it affected his or hers, whatever the the avocado's gender was. It affected it. And it had to adjust into that soil for it to grow again. How did it have to adjust? By trimming some of the things that it had on its life and then growing again. And what does that mean? Well, you get to know the area you're in. You get to know around you. You get to know what people believe, what they do. And then you start seeing things that maybe in your life are a little different than what they believe. So you learn how to communicate with them in a more clear way, but the only process with that is just communication. Communication goes into understanding, and understanding should move into comprehension, and comprehension should be a clear message. But not everyone is going to be in a place of change. Because remember, the most challenging thing is when you come into an area, you believe different, and people are used to something else than what you bring. The process is learning why people do things that they do, why they're doing it for years. And how can you help in that area with what you believe? I mean, this can be anywhere from business, this can be anywhere from moving into a different country, to a different area or region that you come from. You may have lived, let's say, for example, in Ohio, and you move to Florida, and you're like, wow, culture shock, right? Or you move from, let's say, from a little town in Mississippi, and you go into New York. Very, very different. So there's different beliefs, different characters, different way that people act. New York is very fast paced, very, people are on the go. It's not, I think in New York, the process is, it's not that they're rude as they're known for. It's just that there are people that are on the go 24/7. And when people are on the go, they literally have no time to stop and have a conversation. That's the difference. So, I mean, the cultures are very different. Very different in any area you go or any region. There's something that they came from, whether it had been from the Middle East, from Asia, from Russia, from India, from all those things or all those areas that New England, France, they all come from a certain belief that have transferred over and belief in different things, or sometimes believe in the same thing. But the point is, if you are a person that is being born in the water, Again, everyone of us are like that avocado tree born in the water. And that water can also be the soil, right? Either someone comes into your area that is different, or someone or like yourself goes into an area that is different. So that is today's talk about this process of our life when it comes into beliefs, culture shock, when it comes into society. You know, it's one of the messages, very simple yet very powerful. Why? Because right now we're going through a transformation of how people believe. People are starting to believe things very differently, and for some it's ridiculous, for others it's their life. Again, transformation. What do? We have a clear communication. How do we have clear communication? By talking and understanding one another. Creating that communication, the clear communication, that we are talking about why, the hows, the whats, the where. Because those are key components to understanding each other as humans and ultimately being united as one. But again, that all goes into the process of, are you going to give into a trend? Are you going to give into a belief? Or are you going to stand for what you believe and understand other people on what they believe? And how can you help with your belief? All right? That is the process of being in the water, being born in the water, and moving into a soil. Or being born in the water, you grew up a certain way, a certain belief, and now you're moving into a place that you may not have known. But again, grab that clear communication, grab that place where you are strong in your foundation, but you want to understand the culture you're going into so that you can be ready for anything that comes your way and challenges you. So you're ready to trim some things in your plan so that you can grow stronger and better. And that's what we're all about at Make Limited, because there are circumstances that come into our life that are unexpected, and there are circumstances that come into our life that we cause because of certain things that we do, whether it be moving to another city, another region, another country. We can't force those people that live in that area to start believing the way you believe, because you believe that. But instead, share how you believe and understand why they believe what they believe, and figure out a way to communicate clearly and be able to, you know, come together into an area of peace. And that's one of the most important things that I believe in our time and our life, because a lot of people want to enforce things strongly on each other instead of understanding each other. And that becomes a chaos, and ultimately it becomes a literally, you know, riots, disasters, and it's not pretty. So this right here, it's so crucial and very simple. And I hope that it right now in your place, if you are going through a process of being born in the water and you're being transferred into a soil, into a different place, you know, maybe you don't know, you're going to a next grade and you don't know about that grade, you're going to a university, or you're moving towns, or you had a life, a crisis, or, you know, something's happening within your life at the moment, but you were in a place where it was what you knew, it was what you thought, and you're moving into a different area, whether it be an unknown territory or be a known territory. Remember, stay strong in what you believe. And when you move into a different area that you may not know, make sure that you yourself are strong in what you believe. Again, I repeat it because it's very important. And then secondly, understand the society, the culture, and how can you bring yours and add to it or benefit from the things that they're doing into your culture. And how can you work with it? How can you make peace with it? How can you grow with it? And how can you influence others through what you do? And that is key. That is key. It's not about forcing people to believe what you believe. It's about how can you influence? How can you help? And that's the key. That's the key to everything. So if you're not helping anybody with your belief, I say this strongly, because I believe that if your belief is something that damages people, it should not be something you should probably share. But if your belief is helping people for the better, then it's something that people need to hear. Not forcefully, just hear. Not shoved into people's face, but something people should hear. Because people have the option to believe and have the free will to know something. And if they want to accept it, they accept it. If they don't, they don't. But it's our free will to share, and it's our free will to accept. Remember that. All right, guys. Thank you so much for being on our podcast today. And I hope that you were motivated to be better humans today. And we'll talk to you later. Peace. All right, everyone, thank you so much for being with us today. I'm so glad that you were here motivated to be better humans, because I know when you come to Make Limited Podcast, you want to be better. You want to find information that can help your life, and this is what Make Limited Podcast is all about. Now, if you want more of Make Limited Podcast, you can always go to our website on www.makelimitedpodcast.com, and you can find more information there about what Make Limited is doing and the things that we're coming into the future by signing up to our newsletter, and we will send you information. You'll be the first to know about what Make Limited is doing and updates for Make Limited Podcast. I'm super excited. Also, you can leave comments on there. You can also leave a comment on what you want to hear on Make Limited Podcast, or what you want to talk about. Maybe there's some information that you want to leave, and now you can communicate with us faster through that process. Also, you can send your message through Anchor and send that information to us by voice message or by text. You can send it to us, and I'm super excited with technology and how far we've come with this whole process, and it's amazing, guys. We're being heard around the world, where people's lives are just being helped and motivated to be better humans, and that is the process that we want to motivate and promote here at Make Limited Podcast. So thank you so much for being with us here today. We're super glad and thankful that you joined us and were a part of today's podcast. So thank you so much, everyone, and we'll talk to you next time. This is your host, John, with Make Limited Podcast, and we'll be talking to you later. Peace.